In yet another move to reorganize his inner circle, the head of TIT has made new changes that have seen the return of former Roads Minister Franklin Bett. Bett now takes over as the chair in the multi-billion shilling agricultural finance corporation that has been facing governance challenges. The former Bureti MP contested the job primaries in the recently concluded senatorial by-election in Kericho but lost to Aaron Cheruiyot. The former State House controller might have been rewarded for his loyalty, having thrown his weight behind Cheruiyot in the mini poll. Also back in government is former police boss Matthew Iteere, who will now chair the Nyayo T-Zones Development Authority after his exit as police commissioner in controversial circumstances. Nzioki Waita becomes the first deputy chief of staff in Jubilee government after he was appointed to deputize Joseph Kinyua in a move that, according to State House, is geared towards smooth implementation of government agenda. Nzioka's appointment is meant to strengthen the capacity and responsiveness of the office of the president. Renowned lawyer Katwa Kigen, currently representing former radio journalist Joshua Arap Sang at the ICC, has earned himself a state appointment as the man in charge of the unclaimed assets authority. Deputy President William Ruto's perceived loyalist and former Konoin MP Julius Kunez gets another 3 years at the helm of National Water Conservation and Pipeline Corporation. Equity CEO James Mwangi will continue serving as the chair of Vision 2030 Delivery Board as his term was renewed for yet another 3 year term. Former Imenti North MP Silas Muriuki is now the new chair at the local authority's Provident Fund. Eric Biegon reporting for Channel One News.